This is Racer News. I'm Brooklyn.
I'm Addie, and today is October 2nd, 2023.
I'm Eva. Let's take a look at our sports. Our football team has a game this Thursday at West Oak. Our volleyball team has two games. Tonight's game is at home against Powdersville. Wednesday game is at Riverside. We want to congratulate the 7th grade boys who ran in the Lakeland Invitational Cross Country Meet. They finished third overall and competed against runners in 7th through 9th grade. Finishing first for Wahala was Cole Pitts, followed by Finn Powell, Hagen Gosnell, Ben Garland, Cade Pitts, Mo Thiebolt, Jake Garland, Jackson Gillard, and Logan Lindley. Great job, guys!
Hawks for Heaven will meet every Wednesday from 8 to 8:30. Everyone is welcome.
Baseball practices start tomorrow and Thursday and will be from 4 to 5:30 p.m. After fall break, practice will take place on Mondays and Thursdays. Players must have a physical on file. They can be turned into the WMS front office. Players may ride the shuttle bus to the high school, but must bring a note from home and turn it into the front office. Practice will not take place on fall break.
There will be an open gym for girls basketball October 23rd through 25th. Tryouts to be on the girls' basketball team will be on October 27th and 28th from 4 to 5:30, and the team will be announced at the end of the day.
Hispanic Heritage Month is September 15th through October 16th. Here's this week's fact about the Latinx communities in our country. Most of the Hispanic culture, traditions, and values in America come from Mexico, with descendants covering 61% of the Hispanic American population.
Fall break is next week on October 9th through the 13th. I can't wait to enjoy the time off. What are you going to do?
I'm going to go on vacation with my bestie Boo Boo Ireland.
That's nice.
Well, but that's a wrap for this week's announcements.
Thanks for tuning in.
Bye Pookie Bears!
Hey, I'm Cheyenne, and today we're doing the poll of the week. What would you rather, pancakes or waffles?
Waffles, because on pancakes, like, all the toppings, like, fall off of it. When it's waffles, it goes in the little holes.
Pancakes, because you can, like, spread the butter on the pancakes more easily than in the waffles, because the holes in the waffles, yeah, you have to, it gets stuck, and it's hard, and then it's aggravating, and then I can't enjoy my food when I'm yelling at my waffles. So I like pancakes.
Waffles.
Why is that?
Well, whenever I put the syrup on the waffles, the little squares get like all the syrup, so then I can just like, none of the syrup will get on the plate, so it's way better.
Pancakes.
Why is
Because pancakes are fluffy and waffles are hard.
Waffles.
Why?
You can have more flavor. Waffles have more flavor.
Pancakes.
Why?
Because I like chocolate pancakes.
Waffles. Why?
Because they have that you can put more stuff on them.
Waffles.
Why?
They're just fluffy. I think they're just fluffier.
Relatable.
Waffles.
Why?
Because they're crunchy.
Here are the results for our Razor News poll. Waffles or pancakes? We had 153 responses. 59.5 of you say waffles are superior. And 40.5 of you said you prefer pancake. Thanks for voting.
Hi, I'm Avery, and today I'm here with Miss Lawler for The More You Know.
Hey, did you know that musculoskeletal and connective tissue disorders and diseases are the number one cause of disabilities? Diseases of the nervous system and sensory organs are the number two cause.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm here with
Mrs. Tao.
For the must read.
So I want to recommend this book. It's called Scythe, and it is a series. If you like dystopian novels, then this is just a really interesting plot. It's a perfect society. Nobody dies. Everybody has everything they need. You can access all of the world's knowledge if you want to. The only way they control the population is through scythes, which are assassins. And the book follows two teens that are chosen to be apprentices and they don't want to be. And it's just a really interesting twist at the end. And if it's a little bit more mature, so on the young adult side, so if you know you don't like stuff like that, it's not for you. But if you enjoy those kind of stories, then I highly recommend Scythe and the whole series.
Thank you, Ms. Dow.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Alexis and I'm with Ms. Hollerin for the Spanish Phrase of the Week.
Hola, la frase, the phrase for today is hasta luego. And again, it is hasta luego.
Hasta luego.
That means see you later.
For this week's Vox Pop, we asked students, is Nightmare Before Christmas a Halloween movie or a Christmas movie?
Hello, my name is Mallory, and we are here with
Ariana.
Okay, in Nightmare Before Christmas, do you think it's a horror movie or a Christmas movie?
Christmas movie.
Why?
Because it's all about Christmas.
Horror movie.
Why?
It's just kind of scary.
Christmas.
Why?
Just because it is.
Horror movie.
Why?
It still kind of creeps me out.
What do you think? Is Nightmare Before Christmas a Halloween movie or a Christmas movie?
Welcome to a new segment called Finn's Phrase of the Week. Take it away, Finn.
Let him cook moment.
What does it mean?
Let him cook because you're letting him cook. Don't let him cook. But when you let him cook, you are absolutely letting him cook. When you cook, it is absolutely your cooking. Because let him cook when you don't let him cook. Let him cook moment.
This is Razor News Trivia.
Hi, I'm Brooklyn, and I'm here with...
Connor.
So, Connor, what color was George Washington's white horse?
White.
Okay. Hi, I'm here with...
Davina.
So, Susan's dad has three daughters. July, June, and...
August.
No. Susan's dad has three daughters.
Susan.
Yeah, Susan.
Christian, I'm here today with...
Dr. Silva.
What color was George Washington's horse?
George Washington's horse?
Yeah.
White?
Yeah. Hi, I'm Ashton, and I'm here today with...
Stella Wilson.
What's the capital of South Carolina?
Paramount Plus.
No.
No, that's too cold. Oh, I it's on like the tip of my tongue. Columbia.
Yeah. Hi, I'm Ashton, and I'm here today with...
Graham Nobles.
What movie did Jason play in?
Friday the 13th.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm here with Mr. Dixon for the trivia. Mr. Dixon, what is the capital of Mexico?
Capital of Mexico. Acapulco.
Do you know?
Yeah, it was Mexico City. Hey, you tried. Good job.
I just want to know if you knew.
Thank you.
What's the name of the band who sings Basket Case?
Basket Case? Okay, you're talking on Green Day? Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Another one.
What's the name of the band who sings Thunderstruck?
Thunderstruck is AC/DC.
Yep.
Keep going.
What's the name of the band who sings All Apologies?
That would be Nirvana.
I
have a question for you. Who sings the song Blame It on the Rain?
Give me another one.
Most people would say Milli Vanilli.
No, I don't know.
But they actually lip synced it, so it really wasn't Milli Vanilli. Hey, Corbin, I have a trivia question for you. What's the capital of South Carolina?
Columbia.
So, what's the capital of Mexico?
Mexico City.
Columbia?
No.
Columbia, South Carolina.
That's the capital of South Carolina.
Okay. What's the capital of Georgia?
Atlanta.
What's the capital of Mississippi?
Jackson.
I didn't say who is the capital of Mississippi.
No, Jackson is the capital.
Ah, gotcha. Very good. Who's the quarterback for the Panthers?
Bryce Young.
Who's the best quarterback in the NFL?
Controversial.
Patrick Mahomes all day? Mm-hmm. Okay. Better than Tom Brady?
Not yet.
Never. Very good.
What?
Cut.
Hello, I'm here for the Dance of the Week with Mr. Kelly.
Hi, this is going to be the twist. Chubby Checker. My version, anyway.
Come on, baby. Oh, yeah. Let's do the twist. Come on, baby. Let's do the twist. Hey,